ಅರ್ಥ ನಿಷೇಧ ನ ಕ್ರತ್ವರ್ಥಮಿ ಆಸ್ಕಂದತಿ. ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ದ ನಿಷೇಧ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಬಲ್ ಟು ರಾಗದ್ವೇಷ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ವೆನ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಟು ಕ್ರತು ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಡ್. ಅನ್ಯಥಾ ವಾಕ್ಯ ಭೇದ, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಒನ್ ವಾಕ್ಯ ಈಸ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಮೋರ್ ದನ್ ಒನ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ವಾಕ್ಯ ಭೇದ. That this vakya should mean this in given condition and should mean something else in another condition. That cannot be. One vakya should have one meaning. That is why when you want a special application, another vakya must be there. Otherwise, you do not know what to do. If one statement can be interpreted differently under different conditions, then you don't know how to interpret that. That is why to help us interpretation, these other vakyas are also given. Anyatha vakya vedat. Nahi, nahim syadidi. ಕ್ರತು ಪ್ರಕರಣೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೋ ನ ಹಿಂಸಾದಿ ಕ್ರತು ಪ್ರಕರಣೆ ತೌ ನ ಪಶೌ ಕರೋತಿ ಇತಿವತ್ ಆಮ್ನಾತಂ. ಸೋ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ರತು ಪ್ರಕರಣ. ಕ್ರತು ಪ್ರಕರಣ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿ ವೇರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯಾಗ ಇಸ್ ಬೀಂಗ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಯು ನೋ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಡ್ ತೌ ನ ಪಶೌ ಕರೋತಿ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೇ ದಿಸ್ ತೌ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟು ಪಶೌ ನ ಕರೋತಿ ಹಿ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಡೂ ಟು ದಿಸ್ ಪಶು ಇತಿವತ್ ನ ಆಮ್ನಾತಂ. And so, Naim Syad is not found in the Prakarana of the Kratu. Some statement, Tauna Pashav Karodi, something you should not do to the Pashu, whatever it is, you know, you have to go back to the Vedas to find what that statement means. But you should not do something to the Pashu. That's what is said in the Kratu Prakarana. But it is not said, Naim Syad Sarabhutan. If it was said there, then Pashu would be included. Kratvartha Pashu also would be included by that rule. Tasmat Bhinna Gochara Charitvat. ನ ಭೂತ ಅಹಿಂಸಾ ವಿಧಿ ಅಗ್ನಿಶೋಮೀಯ ಹಿಂಸಾ ಬಾಧಕ ಇತಿ ಭಾವ. ತಸ್ಮಾತ್ ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ಭಿನ್ನ ಗೋಚರ ಚಾರಿತ್ವಾತ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್. ನಹಿಂ ಸ್ಯಾತ್ ಸರ್ವಾಭೂತಾನಿ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಗ್ನಿಶೋಮಿಯಂ ಪಶುಂ ಆಲವೇದ ಇಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್. ನ ಭೂತ ಅಹಿಂಸಾ ವಿಧಿ ದೇರ್ಫೋರ್ ದಿ ವಿಧಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹರ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎನಿ ಬೀಂಗ್ಸ್. ಅಗ್ನಿಶೋಮಿಯ ಹಿಂಸಾ ಬಾಧಕ ನ. That does not in fact apply, or is not, it cannot exclude or cannot prevent the himsa that is required to be done for Agnishomi. Some people even believe that when an animal is sacrificed in a yaga, the animal's moksha happens, you know, and therefore you are in fact favoring the animal and not hurting. All kinds of explanations are there. But the general explanation that is given is, it is only to restrict the cruelty of this person. Or another explanation is that, in fact, they did not really sacrifice an animal. It was only some pinda made out of dough, you know, flour. So wheat flour or something like that. They would make something out of shape of an animal and that was offered. Or they would make something animal shaped like from bricks and so forth and that would be offered and not a real animal. So different explanations are available there. Then tatraiva smart dushtantamaha. Now how the general rule is not applicable to the special condition, so Shruti dushtanta is given. Now nahim syat sarabhutani general rule, agni shomiyam pashumalabhed is the special rule. So in the Shruti also general rules are given. When there are exceptions to those general rules also. So urdhvamiti. So the next verse was, or the So the verse said, Bhuta Himsa Vidriyasmat Na Agni Shomi Maharavit. That is explained. Urdham Prana Utkramanti Yunaha Sthavire Ayati. So look, this is the maryada in this culture, you know, in the Vedic culture. Sthavire Ayati. When an old person comes, then what happens? Yunaha Prana Urdham Utkramanti. The prana, the life of this young man who is sitting, or a young person who is sitting here, his life leaves him. So when an older person arrives, then the prana, the life breath of this young man or young person departs. That means he will die unless he does something. So what should he do? So anyway, that is what the Tika says, Tarhi sthavira, sthavira darshiva katham punar jivati. Then sthavira darshi yuva. This yuva, the young man who sees the old person arising, if just by seeing the old person reaching or arising, or coming rather, not arising but coming, arriving. So when he sees the old person arriving, his pranas are leaving. Then katham then taristhavirdarshiva katham punarjivati. Then how does he remain alive? If his prana just departs because he sees old man arriving, then how do his pranas then remain? Then says pratyutthana. Then next verse is pratyutthana avivadabhyam punastan pratipadyate. So what should he do? Pratyutthana. He should arise. So when an old person is arriving, then this young person should arise and to show the respect and avivadana and introduce himself, announce himself that I am so and so. That's called avivadana. So pratyutthana or respecting or you know or showing the words of courtesy to receive that person. So welcoming him. So therefore, when a young person sees an old person arriving, then his or her prana would live unless that person gets up and welcomes the old person. Then his prana will come back. Punastan pratipadyate, he gets his prana back. This is how. This is general rule. The general rule is what? That when you see an old, now old is what? Vayovruddha, tapovruddha, jnanavruddha. So whenever we see someone elder to us, elder in age, elder in austerity, or elder in wisdom arriving, then we should stand up and respect them and welcome them. This is the maryada, this is general rule. But then, that verse says, idi autsargikam acharam. This is autsargika achara, this achara or a code of conduct, which is what we call a general rule. Yatha brahma pravadate. But brahma, there is a particular priest called brahma who invoke pravadate, who ignores this. Even the general instruction also is ignored. Who is brahma? The Tika explains. Ruttik visheshah brahman pravargena ityadav sambodhyamanah brahma yati uchyate. So a certain priest is called brahma. Generally he is a priest of Atharva Veda. So there is the priest of the Rig Veda who is called the he is called Rahota. The Yajur Veda is called Advaryam. The Sam Veda is called Udgata and the Atharva Veda priest is called Brahma. Somebody said that because Atharva Veda was not there included, you know, so now Atharva Veda priest is given the highest position, Brahma. So he is the supervisor. The first three priests have to do things, you know. And so Samaveda, of course, the Udgata has to invoke the devatas and the Advarya has to make offering to the devata. And then the Udgata, so there is Samaveda priest, he sings the gana in the praise of the devata. So all the three priests have something to do. Atharvavedin has nothing to do. He is Brahma and he supervises his fellows. So Brahma is then the supervising priest. He is the senior most priest. So iti ausargikam acharam yatha brahma pravadate. But this rule that now when you see an older person coming, that you should stand up and welcome him, that is ignored by this priest called Brahma. The Tika says, saha katham ausargikam acharam badate. How come the general rule is being ignored by this Brahma? Tatra agachati. So next verse is, agachati gurau tushrim asinah. So even when Guru arrives, so when the ritual is going on, when the yaga is going on, and Brahma is now supervising this, at that time, even if Guru arrives, then you must stand up. In fact, Brihaspati arrived in Indra's sabha, and Indra did not get up. Because of the grace of Brihaspati, that Indra and Devatas won the battles, and Indra became haughty, became a little proud. So even when Brihaspati entered the sabha of Indra, he did not get up. That's all. The Guru was upset. He went disappeared from there. And from then on, the Devatas were without a Guru. And they had a lot of problems. But anyway, so this is how things are. So here, agachati gurau. So now, suppose this ritual is going on and Brahma is there performing his role. At that time, agachati gurau, Guru is coming. Sati Sattvami. Tushrim asinaha. Even then, he remained, no, he doesn't even stand up. and doesn't welcome him also, he remains quiet. Why does he do that? Says here, tasya vagadi visarge karma brahmashaditya. So at that time, when he, let us say, welcomes his teacher and says something, that will only interrupt the ritual that he's doing. So the ritual, perform the ritual, requires him to do certain thing. And now if he wants to welcome the teacher, then he has to ignore the instruction of that particular ritual. So that's an exception. The exception is more powerful than general rule. That generally speaking, yes, he is expected to get up and welcome the teacher. But here, this specific case requires him to keep quiet. Let us say, then that is what he should do. So this vishesha rule or the rule in the special case is far more stronger than the general rule. So this is smart. The smart dushtanta is given a shraudha dushtanta and a smart dushtanta. Okay. All right. So what does it have to do with what we are discussing? This is dushtanta. Now all of this is general discussion. That a special rule. So a general rule is not applicable in special conditions where special rule is applicable. Okay, that's a general rule. How does that general condition rule apply here? Darshtantikamaha. So how does that general rule apply to the darshtanta, shama, dama, uparama, etc. So in case of karma also there is general rule and there is special rule. So what is that? Tadvat. And so, tadvat atracha. Here also a similar condition obtains. Atra means what? Tika se atra iti shamadi vaktyoktihi. Therefore, in this vakyokti, tasmad evamit shantaha dantaha uparataha. Here also, this kind of a situation is there. That shantaha dantaha, they talk about a general rule, and there is a special condition where the general rule will not be applicable. And then uparata is therefore required to give yet special rule to the special rule. There can be exception to exception. You have to look at Sanskrit grammar to find all of this. There is a rule, there is an exception, and exception to exception also. Here something like that is happening here also. Say that the tika, and no, the verse, outsargegatyaga vidhim nitya karma vidhir balat. So utsarga tyagavidhi, the shanta danta is the tyagavidhi, the general rule for this mumukshu, that he should give up all the karmas performed by external limbs as well as by the mind. Nitya karma vidhi balat, tasya jivana matraika hetutvat badate dhruvam. So nitya karma vidhi, so this utsarga tyagavidhi, nitya karma vidhi, outsarga tyaga vidhim balad badate. So there is nitya karma vidhi. What is nitya karma vidhi? Yavad jivam agnihotram juhuyat. As long as one is alive, one should perform the nitya naimitik karma. That becomes stronger than this general vidhi, shantaha, dantaha, that one should give up all karmas. So nitya karma vidhi balad outsarga tyaga vidhim badate. And therefore, he displaces, or it is an exception to that general rule. The Tika explains, tyaga vidhi shanto bhavet ityadi outsargika tyaga vidhi. What is outsargika tyaga vidhi? Shantaha dantaha iti outsargika tyaga vidhi. So that is a general rule for the mumukshu, that he should give all karmas. Katham yavad jivadi vidhi tasya badakaha. All right. So nitya karma vidhi is what? Yavad jivadi vidhi. So how come this nitya karma vidhi or the vidhi of the yavad jiva, how come that also displaces the general vidhi of shamaha, damaha, shanto, dantiri, dvayoho, vaidika vidhitva visheshat, both are vaidika. Shanto danta also is stated by the Veda and yavad jivam also is stated by the Veda. How can it be that what is stated by Veda in one place denies what is stated in another place? You yourself told me the other day. You told me to do this. I know I told, but I am telling you now to do this. You know, this is what happens. This is the kind of dialogue that we hear, you know. You told me to do this. That is all right. But now I am telling you to do this. So what I said that day was a general rule. What I am telling you now is something special. Applicable in this special case. That's all. Or what I said doesn't mean that you have to do it every way. You have to use your sense. I said it all right, but you must use your sense. And then you must have some common sense also as to where the general. Some people, of course, depends on how you want to use a vidhi and so forth, you know. And therefore you can make it an issue anyway. And so you told me, that's why I did it. Knowing fully well that it should have been used anyway, because you told me. And then make prachar, you know, that this is what that person told, and that's why I've done it anyway. Whatever. So people can use the vidhi as they like. People can use exception also as they like and so forth anyway. So, but what I'm saying is, all of these things are day-to-day affair. See, the Vedas also function in the manner in which human mind functions. So question is here, how can what the Veda says in one place is exception to what Veda has said in another place? How can it be so? So, Vaidika Vidhitva Avisheshat, both are Vaidika Vidhi. So how can you say that one Vidhi or one injunction here, or one instruction here, it overrules another instruction? How can you say that? So tasse, therefore the verse is, tasse jivan matre ke hetutvat bhadate dhruvam. Tasse jivan matre ke hetutvat. Otherwise you won't be alive. I think what is meant is that, yavat jivam agnihotram juhuyat, you should do agnihotra nitya nemita karma as long as you are alive, meaning that you will remain alive only if you do that. Sharira yatra vichade na prasidyet akarmanaha. Lord Krishna says, if you akarmanaha, if you just fold up your hand and do nothing and not participate, sharira yatra vichade na prasidyet, you will not be able to sustain your body. And so, niyatam kuru karmatvam karma jayo hya karmanaha. May you perform nitya naivadi karma. Karma jayo hya karmanaha, because karma or participation, is at any rate better than non-participating. Sharira yatra vichate na prasiddet akarmanaha. Therefore, if you stop participating, that means if you stop contributing, whatever contribution, niyatam karma is, everybody is supposed to contribute something in a scheme of things. If you stop doing that, then this scheme will not support you. So therefore, tasya jivan matraika hetutvat, I guess that's how you understand, that this yavad nitya nemiti karma is supposed to sustain your life, because they don't give you any other result, no other reward is there. Bhadate dhruvam, and therefore, when it comes to sustaining your life, well, it is more important than even moksha and stuff like that, whatever it is. And therefore, bhadate dhruvam. And therefore, this nitya karma vidhi definitely is an exception to the general rule of giving up the karma. So you can give up all karmas. Raga prapta karma you can give up. Raga prapta karma is the kamya karma. So then, just as the nahimsyat sarabhutani is to prohibit what we call the violence that arises because of one's own impulses. Similarly also, this karma that are to be given up by Shantadanda are those karma which are performed by one's own impulse. That's kamya karma. So you would say that Shantadanda is only applicable to kamya karma. And when it comes to nitya karma, no vidhi can tell you to give up nitya karma, because nitya karma is that which is required, which is not out of raga. It is because you should do. That's what the Shruti says. And perhaps that is because that is what is going to sustain your life, otherwise not. So, bhadate dhruvam. Then Tika continues. We are on the page 13 and 12, second line. Shamadi videhe outsargirasya apavadaya pravutta yavad jivadi videhe apavadartham uparda shrutihiri phalitamaha. So now, shamadi videhe outsargirasya. So now we have one general rule of shamadi for a mumukshu, that give up all the karma. Then that should be yavad jivam agnihotram juhuyat. That becomes an exception. That give up all the karma except nitya naimitik karma. सुतस्य अपवादतया प्रवृत्तया और प्रवृत्त यावत् जीवादि विधेः. सो दिस यावत् जीवादि विधि हैज इट्स स्कोप वेयर दिस शमदमा दिस विधि इन जनरल एंड दिस इज दैट ऑल राइट व्हेन इट कम्स नित्य कर्मा दैट शुड नॉट बी गिवन अप. सो अपवादतया प्रवृत्त सो दिस नित्य कर्म श्रुति is an exception to the general rule, even for a mumukshu. Pravutta yavad jivadi videhe apavadartham. So now it becomes, even for a mumukshu also, nitya karma should not be given up. Then there is an exception to that. What is it? That when you have the vairagya, when you have mumuksha, then even the nitya karma also should be given up. That's all. So, apavadartham uparata shruti, exception to the exception. So Uparata Shruti is an exception to the Nitya Karma Shruti or Yavad Jiva Shruti. Idi Phalitam Nishet Nitya Idi. It's purely technical discussion anyway. But this also, as I said, the whole Mimamsa is based on our life. These are the kind of things that we encounter in our everyday life. And so when we study the analysis done by the sages of the Veda Vakyas, It also helps us to analyze our own vakyas, our own life, and helps us therefore make proper understand things properly and make proper decisions. So, a discussion like this also cannot be. It is not useless. It is very useful in basically sharpening our own intellect. At the same time, applying this understanding to our different situations. So the next verse on the page 1311, first line, Nitya karma vidheryasmat samadhi vidhina hatihi na samprapta ityatah yatnat prarabdha uparta shrutihi. So Nitya karma vidheryasmat samadhi vidhina hatihi na samprapta, that samadhi vidhi, is samadama this vidhi, hatihi na prapta, it cannot destroy or it cannot overrule the Nitya karma vidhi. See, Nitya Karma Vidhi is apavada or a special rule, and Samadhi Vidhi being general rule, Samadhi Vidhi cannot overcome or overpower the Nitya Karma Vidhi. Like everybody has given certain, like everywhere there is what we call the, a certain power is given, you know. So, everybody is a jurisdiction where his authority will be applicable. But it says, not here. So, that fellow says, here I rule, that's all. This is my territory. And so these dogs and all of these are general territory. But then a certain fellow is a special territory. They will not be allowed. And therefore, this special rule is a special territory. In general territory, okay, you may roam about, but not here. Don't come here. And then in that also there will be somebody who says, well, this is my territory. In that special territory also, somebody can have a special territory. Then. So similarly here, exception to the general rule. Inasmuch as the general rule, namely Shamadama, that does not deny or does not overcome the special rule of Nitya Karma, therefore Ataha Uparata Shrutihi Yatnat Prarabdha. Therefore, to show that even Nitya Karma Vidhi also is an exception. The Nitya Karma Vidhi also is an exception, and that is all education. After all, Vidhi even is nothing but education. That is, Vedantins look upon Vidhi only as that way. Vidhi is not really instruction. Vidhi is not even enjoining you to do something. So Mimamsakas would say that Vidhi do this, in fact makes you do this. And don't do this, makes you not do that. But Vedantins will say that when we are told to do something, it only means that we are told that this is beneficial to you. And we are told to stay away from something, then we are in fact educated that this is harmful to you. So by Vidhi and Nisheda, Vedas only teaches us what is helpful and what is beneficial and what is harmful. Then what to do depends upon me. Even Vedas also cannot compel me to do something. That compulsion must come from within myself. But Vedas educate me. If you do this, well, this is a benefit. If you do this, this is the consequence. I say, I don't care for the consequence. Some people say that and they do it anyway. And so this fellow is told that if you hit your sister, you know, then there will be thorns in your palm. You know? So I don't care. If the thorns come, with that thorn palm I will hit her anyway. So this, there are some fellows who are dusta, that's all they are, you know. And so you can't stop them. Similarly also, even if you, so even if Vedas say don't do this, some fellow will say, I don't care. Then, therefore even Vedas also become helpless. There are some children like that, you know, parents say that, they say, I don't care. Doesn't matter. I have to pull this lorry, I'll do that. Doesn't matter. I'll pull the car. Doesn't matter what happens to me, but I will not do this. I will do this. That's it. The impulse is so powerful that even the consequence of a painful consequence all that, that time doesn't appear to be painful. But the impulse is so powerful. And therefore, Vidya and Nishida, Vedas only can educate us. They cannot in fact compel us to do something. And anyway, therefore the education process continues. There is one thing that we are told, that for mumukshu, that mumukshu should give up all the karmas. Then comes another, wait a minute. If you give up the nitya karma, then your life cannot be sustained. Therefore, nitya karma should not be given up. Then yet another room. If you have got mumukshutvam now, you can give up nitya karma also. Because your life will be sustained by God, that's all. Ananyaha chintayanto maham, therefore yogakshema vahamyam. So now you need not do anything to do can sustain your yogakshema. And now God will sustain your yogakshema. So bhiksha, etc., you know. So that's how his life, livelihood, or his life is sustained, not by himself, but by God in form of society and so forth. I guess so, because we have to make decisions in our life. And for decisions, we should have been enlightened. We should know what to do. And therefore, Veda's role it is to tell us, you know, and thus to educate us. Therefore, then we can make proper decisions. अतः यत्नात् प्रारब्धा उपरतश्रुति ही दैफर उपरतश्रुति यत्नात् प्रारब्ध है व्हाट इज यत्नात् एनीवे सो टीका सेज उत्सर्ग अपवादयोः अपवादस्य बलवत्त्वम् अतः शब्दार्थ है उत्सर्ग अपवादयोः ऑफ द टू उत्सर्ग जनरल रूल एंड फॉर द एक्सेप्शन व्हिच वन इज स्ट्रॉन्गर अपवादस्य बलवत्त्वम् That exception or special rule is stronger than the general rule. Ataha. So ataha. Na samprapta iti. See, the special rule of nitya karma is stronger than the general rule of samadama. Ataha. Therefore. Then somebody says, but which is special rule and which is general rule? We may think that yavat jivamagni hotram juhuyat. That may you not give up your nitya karma for the whole of your life, that's the general rule. And shantaha danta is a special rule. Why not that? Which is how I would look at it anyway. But so this is a question here. Nacha shamadi shrutehe yavad jiva shrutehse viparitam utsarga apavadatvam. Why not it be other way around? That yavad jiva shruti is general rule and shamadi shruti is a special rule and that's it. So this is an exception for mumoksha. That everybody, for every talk, Tom, Dick and Harry, all right, yavat jiva shruti. But for mumukshu, shantaha dantrevam vat. Why not that way? Says, no. Utsarga is utsarga, apavada is apavada. General rule is general rule and special rule is special rule. Because if you think that anything can be utsarga, anything can be apavada, then himsa, ahimsa shrutyohopi tatha prasangat. Then nahimsa sarabhutane will become the special rule, and then himsa will become general rule and things like that, it cannot be. So himsa, himsa, shrutyo api, tatha prasangat. If utsarga apavada can exchange the places, then himsa, himsa can also exchange the places. Then na himsa becomes a special rule, and himsa becomes a general rule, and himsa becomes a special rule, you know, something like that. Samanya, vishesha, how do you decide then? How do you decide what is special and what is general? What's the criteria? When two rules are there, how do we know which is general rule and which is special rule? Then there is a way of determining that. Samanya vishayatvena utsargatvat. So utsarga is a general rule, that is what we call a general application. And apavada is a special rule, which is a special application. So when we find that the rule is generally applicable to everybody, then we will call it general rule. And we find that the rule is applicable specially to somebody under certain conditions, we will call it special rule. So there is a way to determine what is utsarga and what is apavada. Now you can't say that this is utsarga apavada anyway. We have to see which is general and which is special. So, Here also, samanya vishayatvena utsargatvad yavad jivashrutehe. So, samanya vishayatvena, now where are we? Now, samanya vishayatvena tayoho utsargapvadatvam prakrutevi tulyam. Samanya vishesha vishayatvena. So, utsarga is samanya vishaya and apvada is vishesha vishaya. Tayoho utsargapvadatvam prakrutevi tulyam. That samadhi utsarga and yavad jivayat apvada, that is here applicable here also. Samadhi videhe antarbahis cheshta matra nivritti vishasya samanya vishayatvena. So shantaha, dantaha means what? Give up all the cheshta. Give the cheshtas performed by the sense organs and give the cheshtas performed by the mind. So shantaha, dantaha is applicable all the cheshtas. So samadhi videhe antarbahis cheshta matra nivritti vishasya samanya vishayatvena utsargatva, therefore it becomes a general rule because it is applicable to all the cheshta. Whereas yavad jiva shrutehe agnihotrad vishayatvena apavadat. Yavad jiva agnihotram juhya. So yavad jiva shruti is applicable into certain cheshtas. What? Agnihotradi nitya naimitikrama. Therefore, now shamadama is applicable to all the cheshtas and yavad jiva shruti is applicable only to certain cheshtas. Therefore, we say that this is a special rule and that is a general rule. Yavad jiva shrutehe agnihotradi vishayatvena apavadatva. Therefore, this yavad jiva shruti becomes apavada exception. Atah tat apavadatham. Therefore, now you need apavada of that also. That nitya karma also has to be given up. Then for this particular person, nitya karma also should be given up. Then he becomes apavada of that apavada also. Atahatadapavadartham upadashruti divavaha. Therefore, upadashruti is for apavada of that apavada also. Atah yatna. Therefore, so it is said, atah yatnat prarabdha upadashruti. So upadashruti yatnat prarabdha. What is that? Atah yatnat uktanyayat agatarsattva sambhavat iti yavat. Uktanyaya is what? That exception is stronger than the general rule. Therefore, since even for a sannyasi also, nitya karma will be applicable. Agadarthatva. Therefore, as far as the nitya karma is concerned, is not covered. In sannyasa vidhi also, shamadama, nitya karma will not be covered. And therefore, you have to cover that also. Therefore, yatna specially, to cover the nitya karma also, uparada shruti is there. And so, this is general rule, shamadama, special rule, yavajjiva, yet special rule is uparataha. This is how Vartikara explains this. Okay, we'll continue. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om. Tam. Esha Nityo Mahima Brahmanasya Navardhade Karmana No Kaniya Tasseiva Syat Padavittam Viditva Nalipyate Karmana Papakena iti tasmadevam vita shanto danto paratastitikshu samahito bhutva atmanyevatmanam pasyati sarvamatmanam pasyati nainam papma tarade sarvam papmanam tarade nainam papma tapade sarvam papmanam tapade vipapo virajo vichikitso brahmano bhavate Esha Brahma Loka Samrat Enam Prabhito Siddhi Ho Vache Agni Valkya Soham Bhagavate Videhan Dadami Man Chapi Sahadasya Eti Continuing with the discussion of the Crore Patra at the bottom of page 1310. Nanu Danta Samokteva Sarvaseveha Karmana Vairatattva Dukara Sratyatya Nyatkim Vidhiyate. So question is asked here, what is it that this word Uparatah convey? Shantaha, Dantaha, Uparataha, Tidekshuhu, Samahito, Bhutva. We can understand Shantaha, Dantaha is Nivritti, is cessation or disengagement from all actions, we can understand. But what does this word Uparata, what further disengagement does it indicate? So Shantaha indicates a disengagement from action, Danta also indicates disengagement from other action. Then Bahirantah kriyatonya na kriya vidyate yatah. Shantaha means withdrawal from all internal activities. Dantaha means withdrawal from all external activities. What remains then to be withdrawn from? And therefore, what kind of withdrawal does it uparati mean? No. Then the answer is no. This question or this questioning on your part is not proper. And to show how it is not proper, or how Uparata Shruti has something to convey over and above Shantaha Dantaha, then the Vartikara gives first of all a general rule. Utsarga vidhanayasmat napavadasya vadhanam. Yasmat, because utsarga vidhana, by a general rule, apavadasya vadhanam nay, a general rule cannot dismiss a special rule. It's always the other way around, that a special rule or exception always overrules the general rule and not the other way around. So a general rule cannot overrule the special rule. Gives an example. Bhuta ahimsa vidriyasmat nagne shomi yamarabhet. Just as bhuta ahimsa nahimsat sarva bhutani, so that general rule that one should not kill or one should not hurt any living being, that's a general rule, but it cannot overrule the himsa. The killing of an animal, sacrifice, that is a sacrifice that is involved in Agni Shomiya, in that yaga. So this is the general rule. So this is the Shrauta example. The illustration from the Shruti, Nahimsyat Sarva Bhutani, and then Agni Shomiyam Pashum Alabhed. So general rule and exceptions also. Urdham Prana Utkramanti Unasthavir Ayati Pratyutthana Vivadabhyam Punastan Pratipadyade. So Yuna, not Punaha. Urdhvam Prana Utkram, Yuna Stavira Ayati. So it is said in the Manusmuti that when an older person or respectable person is arriving, then the Prana's life breath of this young person, they start leaving him. Then how does he get his Prana back? Pratyuthana Vivadabhyam. By Pratyuthanam. So by getting arising in respect, in Abhivadaram, by announcing who he is, or by respecting him, welcoming him. So when this gesture of respect is shown to the older person, then the pranas come back. The idea is that whenever an older person arises, and the oldness is determined by age, by austerity, by wisdom, So whenever someone who is old in that sense arises, then one should get up and respect him. That's a general rule. But there also there is exception. Iti autsargikam acharam yatha brahma pravadate. But in a very special case, the priest called Brahma, he doesn't get up even when an elderly person comes. Agacchati garau tushrim asinah. Even when Guru arrives, and then also this Brahma remains quiet, doesn't get up. Why is it so? Because that would then disturb his ceremony. So that would mean whatever is required to do to perform that ceremony, that would be violated. And therefore, in order to avoid one violation, he accepts another one violation. So one violation is a general rule, another violation is that if he talks while the ceremony is going on or gets up at that time, so karma bhramsha ityartha, that karma, the ceremony that is being performed, there will be bhramsha, there will be deviation. And therefore, in order to avoid that violation, he has to accept this violation. So this is the smart example of how a special rule overrules the general rule. So how is it applicable here? Autsargika tyaga vidhim nitya karma vidhi balat tasya jivan matre hetutvat badate dhruvam. This nitya karma vidhi, this vidhi or vidhanam of nitya karma, that one should perform the daily and incidental obligatory duties always. Tasya jivan matre hetutvat, because that is what sustains the life of this person. And if he gives us nitya nimitta karma, he cannot live. He cannot continue to live. And therefore, jivan matre ke hetu tvat. Because the nitya nimitta karma is the very hetu, the reason for his jivanam, for his living. Therefore, balat. So, forcefully, outsargaka tyag vidhim badate. That outsargaka tyag vidhi. Shantaha, dantaha. That one should withdraw from all external and internal activities. That's the general rule for a mumukshu. But then this nitya karma vidhi, that he cannot live, if he gives up his nitya karma, that very forcefully overrules the general rule. Therefore, so Vartikara says that shantaha danta is fine. What you are saying is okay. That between these, the two words, in fact, they bring about disengagement from all activities. However, that is an utsarga, a general rule. And there is another rule that one should not give up this nitya nimitta karma for the whole life. And therefore, that becomes an exception to this rule. In short, even shantaha, dantaha also are not capable of negating the nitya naimitik karma. That's the idea. So even after shantaha, dantaha, nitya naimitik karma still remain. And therefore, uparata shruti is required to show that even they also should be given up. Nitya karma vidhariyasmat samadhi vidhina hatihi na samprapta. So, yasmat, since samadhi vidhina, by this vidhi or enjoyment, shantaha bhutva or dantaha bhutva shantasyat, dantasyat, that vidhi cannot dismiss or cannot overrule the rule or the injunction about the nitya karma. Ataha, therefore, yatnat uparata shruti, yatnat prarabdha. Therefore, this shruti, this uparata, so prarabdha, that now comes into action because of the non-exception, you know. So, because the nitya karma cannot be dismissed, therefore, even to eliminate the nitya karma in the life of the mumukshu, the uparata shruti is there. Alright, now continuing. Ataha yatnad uktanyayat agatarthattva sambhavat iti yavat. So, uktanyayat, that this yavat jiva shruti is an exception to shamadama. Therefore, agatarthattva sambhavat, so the nitya karma still is not dismissed, and therefore uparata shruti is required, so to eliminate that karma also for a mumukshu. So that's page 13 and 12, continuing with the sixth line in the Tika. Uparatihi vidhiyate ched yagadivat karmasya. These are not our problems. These are all problems of Purva Mimamsa actually. But anyway, since this is the discussion with the Purva Mimamsaka, This whenever this sannyasa or disengagement or renunciation of action comes, immediately you have to contend with the Purva Mimamsaka who insists that this nitya karma should never be given. You would not even want to give kamya karma, because otherwise how can you achieve anything? Even desire prompted action also should not be given up, because how can you achieve anything? Life is meant for purushas, for doing something. And therefore, karma should not be given. These are all fellows who have nothing else to do or good for nothing. Or those who don't understand. That is why they dismiss all these sannyasis and other people as unproductive and not useful to society and not useful to themselves, whatever it is. So, against, in fact, Shankaracharya's greatest battle must be against these people, against Mimamsakas. More than Bauddhas, Mimamsakas. Because karma, karma. And then he was a tremendous proponent of sannyasa, of a life of disengagement, of knowledge, basically. Those people of praptasya prapti, of Atma being Brahma, that's it. That Atma is Brahma. So Brahma. And so knowledge. And knowledge requires a mind free from every distraction. There was sannyasa. And sannyasa even of nitya naivitik karma. Why is it so? Because sannyasa is one who has discovered the value for the self's knowledge, has no other obligation. This must be very, you know, this must require tremendous boldness to assert this. In an environment wherein the Mimamsakas are so influential, for centuries the people's mindset is framed in a certain way, to be able to come forward and say this must have required a tremendous amount of strength, but so it requires a tremendous strength. Anyway, and so, and Bauddhas of course are the other extreme. These fellows are one extreme. Both are, they don't accept Ishvara. The problem with both Mimamsakas and Bauddhas, both are Nastikas, in the sense of not accepting Ishvara. Atheist, you know. Astika, Nastika is a technical word. So, in the Vedic parlance, Astika means one who accepts the Pramanya of the Veda, and Nastika is one who does not accept Pramanya of the Veda. That way, Mimamsakas are great Astikas. But they are atheists, because they don't accept Ishvara. They don't see the need of Ishvara. And so they are all dharma-oriented people, you know, there is no bhakti in there. The problem is that this is all cause and effect business. So, the karma and karma phala. And therefore the whole universe is a product of karma. So this jiva produces, performs karma, and this universe is created in response to that. God doesn't have any role to play in that. So that's why he brought in bhakti, Ishvara, you know, and there's Bauddhas also. They don't accept Ishvara also, because everything is created, everything is projection. Projection of the mind. So that's subjectivist. Subject is all there is, and what is so-called objective is all projection of the mind. You don't require any Ishvara to create this. Because it's not a creation, it's all pradivadit satta. They don't accept vyavaharik satta at all. If you accept vyavaharik satta, then alone the Ishvara has to accept it. So, Mimamsakas explain vyavaharik satta by karma. And Bauddhas deny the vyavaharik satta. So both of them don't accept the Ishvara. So, in a way, both of them fall in the same category as far as we are concerned, you know, in a certain sense. That they don't accept Ishvara in that sense, then both of them fall in the same category. But anyway, so all these arguments are to be done, or to be advanced, on the familiar battleground of the Mimamsakas themselves. So, we have to battle with them with their own rules. Otherwise, they will not accept the principle. And so says here, uparatihi vidhiyate che. All right. So uparatasyat. So one should become disengaged completely from all activities. Uparatihi vidhiyate. This is vidhi. Then yaga adivat karmasyat. Swarga kamo yajeta. So just as the desires of swarga should perform a certain yaga, then vidhi means do this. It's a matter of doing, giving, so doing something. So vidhi is what? Do this. Do this means what? Perform an action. So vidhi is always a positive statement of what one should do. Similarly, uparatasyat becomes vidhi, that you must do uparati. Then you must perform the yaga. Similarly, you must perform uparati. If it is vidhi also, uparati also is vidhi, then like a yaga, there also becomes a karma. That's something that should be done. So that's what he said here. Endeavor, yagadivat karmasyat, videhe, bhavartha, vishyatva, niyamat. So that's the niyama. That vidhi is also bhavartha vishaya. So vidhi always has its vishaya or scope with reference to something positive which must be done. So nishedha is that which has its scope in something not to be done. Whereas vidhi has a scope in something that should be done. So bhutva or syat. So here what you should do? Shantaha bhutva, dantaha bhutva, uparataha bhutva. So shanta syat, danta syat, uparata syat, this is what you should become. That is not, this is what you should do. So uparata is also presented here as something to be done, looks like. Yaga adivat karma syat, like yaga, that is enjoined, is something to be positively done. Videhe bhavartha veshyatva niyamat tathacha tadvadeva tyajyada. So, if it is karma, then tadvadeva tyajyata, then if that becomes karma, see the interesting thing is, if uparati also is karma, then if all karma is to be given up, then uparati also should be given up. You follow? If you say that yaga is a karma, therefore by uparata shruti, by uparata vidhi, that should be given up, then uparati also will become karma. Tadvadeva. So if by the uparati, by the rule or injunction, instruction that you must disengage from all karma, if you must disengage from yagadi karma, you must disengage from karma that is called uparati also. Tadvadeva, tyajyata, anyatha, yagadehavi, upadeyata. If uparati, which is karma, so in spite of uparati being karma, if you are going to retain that, then yagadi also should be retained. Because if karma is retained, then any other karma also should be retained. So he wants that. This is all technical point. So videhe bhavartha veshyatva niyamat. A vidhi also has, by as a rule, it always has its scope in something to be done. And uparata syat, if uparati also is a vidhi, then that means that it is something to be done. That means it is karma of some kind, and therefore it also should be given up. Iti ashankaha iha cha iti. So, this ashanka is replied iha cha in the next verse. Page 13:11, second line. Iha cha uparata shrutya tishchatya devuduchyate karma karma eva pumsosya hinushtheyataya mrutehe. Ihacha uparata shrutya tishthati adivat uchyate. Tishthati is a kriyapada. Stha also is a kriyapada. But then tishthati means it stands. And so gati, what is it called? Gati nirodha, isn't it? Gati nivruttav, yes. Stha is in gati nivruttav. Stha means to stand. That means what? Cessation of gati. So every kriyapada doesn't always involve doing something. So there are verb. Kriya pada means what? If pada means a word which actually indicates an action. That's called kriya pada. And then we would expect that every kriya pada, every verb always must involve some action. But tishthati doesn't involve any action. Similarly also, uparataha does not involve an action. This is the idea here. Itikakar explains that. Yatha tishthati swapiti ityadina kriya nivrutti eva uchyate. So tishthati, he stands, swapiti, he sleeps. By that, kriya nivrutti eva uchyate. It is kriya nivrutti, it's disengagement from an action. This fellow is walking, stand. You know, when we say stop, then it is disengagement from action and not doing an action. So tishthati swapiti ityadina kriya nivrutti eva uchyate. It means what is meant there is kriya nivrutti, disengagement from kriya. Tatha upara shrutya, uparata shrutya. Similarly also uparata syat, when it is said by that injunction, nitya karma nivrutti rupam akarma eva karma. Akarma eva karma. There nitya karma nivrutti rupam. Therefore, disengagement from nitya karma, disengagement from daily obligatory, incidental obligatory duties becomes a karma. That is, which is what becomes to be done. That's what the verse says. Ihaja uparata shrutya tishthati adivat akarma eva pumsasya karma uchyate. Asya pumsaha akarma eva karma uchyate. Is akarma. That is disengagement alone is what he has to do. It does involve doing something, let us say. The fellow is walking, yes, you stop walking. If you say it involves doing something, fine. But in fact, it is disengagement from activity. Asya pumsaha akarma eva karma uchyate. That's all. What is akarma? Nitya karma nivritti rupam akarma eva karma uchyate. Uchyate asya anushteyataya akarma eva karma uchyate amrutehe. So until death. So going back to the tika. So nitya karma nivritti rupam akarma eva yavan maranam anushteyam. Asmin vakye vivakshade. So how long should we disengage from nitya karma? Amrutehe anushteyataya amrutehe uchyate. Amrut until death. Yavan maranam, until he dies, as long as alive, let us say. Anushteyataya uchyate anushteyam asmin vakye vivakshade. In this vakye uparateha vivakshade. So what is intended to be stated is that this person should disengage from nitya karma also until his death. Ataha yagadi sadrusha karma vidhi abhavat. Therefore, this is not a karma vidhi. So yagadi sadrusha. In yaga, when yaga is enjoined, it means something that is to be done positively. So yagadi sadrusha karma vidhi abhavat. There is no vidhi or enjoyment here for doing something as in case of yaga. Nishedeshu eva vidhi avasana. So even though uparata syat looks like a statement of what is to be done, in fact it means that, so it is not doing something, but it is disengagement from nitya karma. So this is vidhi in grammatical, you know, in construction of a sentence, but in fact it is a nisheda, this is the idea. So nisheda also is a vidhi. That was stated earlier. Nisheda also, mean not doing something also is a vidhi, is also a rule that you have to follow. So nishedeshu eva vidhi avasana. And therefore that nayartha, that negative particle of negation is brought in, and that way it amounts to vidhi also. Vidhi avasana na ukta anupatti ityartha. And therefore this, so otherwise if uparati is a kriya, it being kriya also, you should give up. That means what? You should take up the kriya. But no, that anupatti will not be there, because even though this uparata syat, it is equivalent to a nisheda. A nisheda is accepted in the vidhi also. Alright, so that technical hurdle is cleared here. Then, asa uparata shrutehe abhiprayam darshayati. Now, what is abhipraya of uparata shruti? Disengagement from what? Anushteyate ayati. Next verse. Anushteyataya shrutya nivritti sarva karmanam yasmad vidhiyate tasmad tatyagi patito bhavet. Yasmad, since shrutya sarva karmanam nivritti anushteyataya vidhiyate. Since shrutya bhaya shruti uparata syat sarva karmanam nivritti anushteyataya vidhiyate. Since this statement uparata syat vidhiyate, it enjoins you that you must disengage from all the karma. Therefore, tasmat tatyagi. So if you even give up uparati, then patito bhavet. So that means that you are transgressing a vidhi. You cannot. So that vidhi means a rule, you know. And therefore, you will be transgressing the vidhi or rule if you give up the uparati, or if you continue to perform action, or if you become uparata. So amrutehe, until death. So suppose you become uparata, meaning become a sannyasi, and then give up the sannyasa at some point in time, then tatyagi patito bhavet. If a person who gives up sannyasa patito bhavet, then he invites his downfall. This is what it seems to be meant here. That's what the tika. Svikrita paramahamsyah jivannevasa amrutehe kya maro. Until death. Svikrita paramahamsyah. So this Paramahamsa Ashrama is this Atyashrama, even beyond the Chaturtha Ashrama. Because if you become a sannyasi as a fourth ashrama, some kartavya still remains there. But here Paramahamsa is what? He is beyond all ashramas, and therefore no kartavya. Sri Gurudha Paramahamsa Jivanneva Tatyajan. And Uparadhi he gives up. Then what? Aspruśya syat. He becomes aspruśya. There are very strict rules, you know. As I said, a very, what shall I say, unforgiving society. No, this is very, anyway, I don't want to again lecture on that, but this is sometimes when you see all this curse, sharp and all that style, you know, and so on, the rules so strictly, the words in which these things are stated seems to be very severe, you know, very severe. And so there is no scope for deviation from the stated rules, that's all. Either this or that. And the aspruśyasya, that's it. Sa nirayarha. Nira means naraka. He only deserves naraka or hell, that's all. Nirayarhasya. Bahistu ubhayatha piri nyayadityartha. Ubhayatha pi bahihi. Neither here, ato bhrashtah, tato bhrashtah. So like the dog of a dhobi, you know, is neither here nor there. Similarly also, he is neither a grihastha. So he gave his grihastha ashrama by accepting Paramahamsa. Now giving up Paramahamsa, he cannot come back to grihastha because aspruśyasya. He is neither here nor there. Therefore, you must be someplace. You must be, you belong to some vyavastha, some structure you must belong to. So therefore, it is a very structured society. Therefore, you must belong somewhere. Abhivade, when you announce yourself, you must have some introduction of yours. I belong to this ashrama and this jnati and this, that, and if you don't belong anywhere, that means then you are gone. Aspruśyasya. So aspruśyata is right there, you know, it's not there, aspruśyata is not there anyway. I don't know, this must come from some place, aspruśyasya. So the people don't like to accept that there is aspruśyata in, maybe there is not, I don't know. Generally it is said that this Jains brought about aspruśyata, you know, that is what some scholars like to say anyway. And so, but anyway, whatever it is, there is a history of aspruśyata. But in Vedas there is no aspruśyata, so it is said. Now we have to really see the whole Vedas. But whether in Smriti it is there or not, in Manusmriti, in places where aspruśyata is there or not, it could very well be there. The fellow is discarded, that's all. And he is debarred from, that means he is socially discarded. So if he remains nowhere, that's as good as hell. Because you can't relate to anybody. And nobody can relate to you. See, one thing about this Varnashrama Vyavastha is that each one knows how to relate to others. Where do you belong, you know, that's all. In which Varna and which Ashrama. I belong to this Varna and this Ashrama. And the rules of what one should, you know, how I should relate to others, they are all specified. How a Vaishya should relate to Brahmana, and Brahmanastri, and Vaishya Purush, and Vaishyastri. Everything, you know, is all specified. What is all possible, what is not possible. And this is all there. And if you if you transgress this, then what happens also? Then you become a Pulkasa, you become Nishada, and you become this, and you become that. And, you know, most of these fellows were all discarded fellows. The fact that they were living all in forest, far away, because I guess they had no entry into the towns. I don't know, whatever it is. I do not know this anyway. But the idea is that they were, if they are untouchable, untouchable means he is removed far, you know. He can't relate to anybody, that's all. And if you can't relate, then there is no social life. There is no life at all for this person. So he as good as lives in hell, that's what it amounts to. This is a way to punish. So this is a very punishing. Or all these old societies, you know, must be very uncompromising. So if you look, there's Judaism there also, very strict rules. Including God also, punishing. That's all. He has a thunderbolt in his hand, and the moment you transgress the rule, that's it, you are punished. So people run away from that God. People, in fact, run away from that God because it is an unforgiving God, you see. So this is a very unforgiving society very often, because moment, you know, sometimes the condition in which the curses are given is amazing. You can't believe that, you know, that a person can be cursed for practically no fault of his anyway. But so, aspruśyasya, that's all. Sa nirayarha syat bahistu ubhayatha piri nyayadityartha. Anyway, so in short, amrute, once you take up sannyasa, you must maintain it for the rest of the life. You cannot then, there cannot be sannyasa from sannyasa also. So there is disengagement from disengagement. That is not allowed. That is, legally it is not allowed. So this is what Uparata Shruti means. Now, another interesting discussion here. Uparata Shruti Nitya Karma Nivrityartha Iti Ukte. Uparata Shruti Nitya Karma Nivrityartha. So this Uparata Shruti is for Nivrutti, disengagement from Nitya Karma. Iti Ukte, this is what is being stated. So this has been said here. Iti Ukte Arthe, Chodya Samadhavu, Chodya Samadhi, Parikya Udbhavayati. Now what has happened is, it looks like somebody has already done this. So somebody has already explained Uparati means sannyasa. And are you saying what somebody else is saying? Oh, you have something more to say. And therefore, Parakiyav Chodya Samadhi, that's a dual. Chodya means a question and Samadhi means Samadhanam. And so, a question is asked and then it is resolved. So therefore, somebody else, Parakiya, whoever it is, so somebody else has also arrived at this conclusion that Uparati means Sannyasa. But the kind of explanation that that person must have given of Uparati is not satisfactory. And therefore, we must give a satisfactory explanation of Uparati. Therefore, Uparata Shruti hi Nitya Karam Nivrityartha iti uktayate. Or maybe this explanation that Uparati means the disengagement of Nitya Karma raises certain questions also. And those questions also need to be addressed. Therefore, Vartikara wants to address the further questions, that is Nitya Karma Shruti, disengagement from Nitya Karma. So, somebody has given an explanation of why this is so. Why should there be disengagement from Nitya Karma also? If Uparati says that you must take sannyasa or renounce Nitya Karma also, why is it so? Somebody has explained why that is so. And if that explanation, according to Vardekar, is not satisfactory, so why Shruti enjoins sannyasa from Nitya Karma? For that, somebody has given an explanation, which explanation is not satisfactory, and therefore, Vartikara wants to give a satisfactory explanation. Looks like this is how. Therefore, Chodya Samadhi Parakiyav Udbhavayati. He raises or brings up here the Parakiyav Chodya Samadhi. So somebody, the kind of an explanation that somebody provided to justify the Uparata Shruti is being presented, is first presented here in order to improve upon that. I guess that's all you can say. Iti yatra iti. The next verse. Iti yatra chodaitvaike pariharam prachakshate nityanam karmanam kasmat parityago vidhiyate. Iti yatra chodaitva eke pariharam prachakshate. So nityanam karmanam kasmat parityago vidhyate iti yatra chodaitva eke pariharam prachakshate. Nityanam karmanam kasmat parityago vidhyate. Let us say that as you explain uparatasyat, meaning nitya karma tyaga. Okay, vidhyate. So nitya karmanam tyaga uparata shrutya vidhyate. This statement Uparata enjoins even the giving up or renouncing the Nitya Karma also. So kasmat parityago vidyate. How can Shruti in fact enjoin the renunciation of Nitya Karma? Idi atra chodaitva. Raising this question. Eke pariharam prachakshate. There are some. So, all right. First of all, technically, it has been established that Uparata Syat means disengagement from Nitya Karma also. Why is it so? So, because Sama and Damaha, Shantaha and Dantaha, even though it appears that they ask us to disengage from all internal and external activities, but then Yavad Jiva Shruti is there, which is an exception to that Shruti, and because of that, the Nitya Karma still remains, that I can disengage only from karmas other than Nitya Karma. Therefore, Uparada Shruti comes and says, no, there is in case of Mumukshu, there is an exception that Mumukshu can give up the Nitya Karma also. This is how Uparada Shruti, in fact, enjoins the disengagement from Nitya Karma also has been established. Now, that's all right, but why is it so? Question is, why does Shruti enjoin the renunciation of Nitya Karma also? Why? So, Shruti enjoyment is fine, but there must be reason also. So, technically you arrive at this conclusion that Uparata Syat means disengagement from all karma. Okay. But then whatever rules or enjoyments are given, so Vidhi, Vidhanam is given, it must be reasonable. Shruti also cannot ask us to do something that is unreasonable. So, Vartikara says that some people provide reasoning as to why Shruti enjoins disengagement from Nitya Karma also. So, Idi Chodaitvatra Eke Pariharam Prachakshate. There are some who give an explanation as to why Shruti enjoins renunciation of Nitya Karma by Uparata, by the statement Uparata. Then Tikagara says, Kautau ityakangshayam chodyam tavad darshati. Kautau. Kautau chodya samadhi. What is that question and what is the explanation? Then, ityakangshayam, that akangsha is there. So, because Vartikara says, ityatta chodaitva eke pariharam prachakshate. Iti chodaitva and pariharam. So, what is it? So, first of all, the question is given. Chodyam tavad darshati nityanam karanam kasmat. So, kasmat parityago vidhiyate. This is the question. How can there be a parityaga or renunciation of nitya karma? Say the tika, yavad jiva shruti shoditanam akasmat tyaga ayogaha. So, yavad jiva shruti chodana, so that karma that is enjoined by the yavad jiva shruti, all of a sudden, tyaga ayogaha, it is not proper. Suppose shruti has said uparatasyat, that means that shruti says, all right, give all nitya karma also. Akasmat means what? Without reason. Kasmat means reason. Akasmat is without reason. So, kasmat tyago vidhiyate. What is the reason why the Shruti is now telling us to give up the Nitya Karma also? The idea is that there cannot be, Shruti cannot do that. Akasmat means without reason. Accidentally akasmat. So therefore, akasmat tyaga ayogaha. Akasmat tyaga ayogaha means what? It is not proper to give up that Nitya Karma which are enjoined by another vidhi. There is a vidhi that says that you must do Nitya Karma and an unreasonable. A dismissal of that or overruling of that without reason is not proper. Nacha uparata shrutihi tat tyaga hetuhu. This is a questioner says this. Nacha uparata shrutihi tat tyaga hetuhu. Therefore the questioner says that really uparata shruti does not mean that you should give up nitya karma. Because akasmat, all of a sudden, without reason, why should Shruti ask you to, why should Shruti overrule the rule that itself has made? Nacha uparata shrutihi tatyage hetuhu. Therefore we say that uparata shruti is not the reason for giving up the nitya karma. Then what? Tasyaha kamya karamatra tyagarthatvat. So by uparata shruti, what is meant to be given up is only kamya karma and not nitya karma. This is what a Purvapakshi says. How did you arrive at this? Kamyanam karmanam nyasam sanyasam kavayo viduhiti smutehe. So Lord Krishna himself says, what is sanyasa? Kamyanam karmanam nyasam. That is why Shankaracharya spent a lot of time there also. Then Lord Krishna says, Kamyanam Karvanam Nyasam Sanyasam Kavayo Viduhu. Bhashyakara had a hard time with that. Lord Krishna seems to define sannyasa. Renunciation is what? Kamyanam Karvanam Tyaha. Renunciation of desire prompted action is called sannyasa, not nitya karma. So Mimamsaka and other people, proponents, had a very specific tool in their hand, a weapon rather. Lord Krishna has specifically said, Kamyanam Karvanam Nyasam Sanyasam Kavayo Viduhu. Therefore, a long discussion that this is, who is told this? Who is being told? Is a general statement that is told to a mumukshu? Or is it a statement made with reference to a grihastha or a karma yogi? It is for karma yogi that Kamyanam Karvanam Nyasam Sanyasam Kavayo Viduhu. For a karma yogi, it is said that giving a kami karma is for him a sannyasa. Even though he performs nitya nirmiti karma, then also that is also called sannyasa. So there Lord Krishna uses the word sannyasa not in a primary sense but in a secondary sense. Why? To extol the kind of renunciation that is shown by a karma yogi. What is the spirit of renunciation? What spirit does a karma yogi show? That he gives up all kamya karma. Or sarva karma phalatyaga. So, or sarva karma phalatyaga, giving up the attachment to karma phala is also, so that is the renunciation that displays, and therefore that tyaga is praised as sannyasa. Bhashyakara had to say that the word sannyasa is used in an upacharika manner, in a gauna in a secondary sense and not in a primary sense. That is a debate, you know. And so, then you must use the rules of Mimamsa and everywhere else. So, nahi deha vrata shakyam tektum karmanya sheshataha yattu karma phalatyage satyage tyabhidhiyate. See, Lord Krishna later on says, yattu karma phalatyage. So, one who renounces the karma phala, he is called tyagi. But tyagi is not sannyasa. He says, no, tyaga and sannyasa mean the same thing. That also another thing had to be clarified. Because sannyasasya mahabaho tattva vichyana vedutam tyagasya charushikesha prasakkesha nishudana. Arjuna asked explanation of these two words, sannyasa and tyaga. So if Lord Krishna says, so yattu karma phala tyagi satyagi tabhijayate, the giver up of the karma phala is called tyagi, but he's not sannyasi, that fellow will say. Sannyasi is a person who gives up kamya karma and things like that. So Bhashyakara also established that the words tyaga and sannyasa mean the same here. They are not like ghatapada, they are not totally different words, but then they essentially mean the same thing. That is the reason why Lord Krishna does not use the word sannyasa subsequently, use the word tyaga alone, meaning that the word sannyasa and tyaga do not have separate meaning or do not have totally different meanings. Long discussion took place there in the beginning of 18th chapter. Because of this, kamyanam karmanam nyasam sannyasam kavayo viduhu, because kavaya says, so the wise people say that it is kamya karma tyaga is sannyasa. So anyway, so this is how kamyanam karanam tyagam. Therefore he says here that uparati, even if it means sannyasa, it cannot be sannyasa of nitya karma, because sannyasa means only sannyasa of kamya karma. It is smrute. And therefore, shavadama shruti vyameva tat siddhe. So shantasyat, dantasyat. So by those statements, the kamya karma is already given up. Therefore, tatyaga chodana vrutha. So uparata shruti becomes vrutha. So therefore, he says uparata shruti is not tatyaga hetu. That's all. Uparata shruti is not the hetu for tyaga of kamya karma, of nitya karma. Because sannyasa, if uparata means sannyasa, sannyasa is not a hetu for tyaga. Sannyasa means it is sannyasa of kamya karma, and renunciation of kamya karma is already implied or is already indicated by shama and dama. Shama dama shruti bhyameva tat siddhehe tad vayarthye. Therefore, siddham na samihitam iti bhavaha. And so, tad vayarthye. So then uparata shruti, if it is interpreted as sannyasa, then it will be vyartha, because that sannyasa is already indicated by shama and dama, shantaha dantaha. So, naha samihitam siddham. Therefore, kasmat parityaga vidyate. So, we say that the samadhana that we say is siddham. Samahita means that samadhana. Iti bhavaha. Tatra parigiyam samadhan. Somebody else gives samadhanam for that. You know, this question is replied by somebody. Kamyadeti. This is so difficult to understand because if this Tikakara did not tell you all of this, even after his telling it is difficult to understand, but if he did not tell you all this, who can understand what is being said by Vartikara? So even though Vartika is supposed to be a detailed explanation of Bhakti, in itself is so brief, you know. Vartikara himself is like sutra. Sometimes these vakyas are sutratmaka, which require a lot of explanation. Anyway, so nityanam karmanam kasmat parityago vidhyate. Then parakiyam samadhi. Samadhanam, or the explanation or the reply of this question that is given by somebody, is presented here. Looks like siddhanti, but not quite. Kamyadi. Kamyadi karmavattesham mano vyakshepa hetutah tyagotas chodyate shrutya nityanavi karmana. Kamyadi karmavattesham nitya karmana. So tesham nityanavi kamyadi karmavat mano vyakshepa hetutah. Vyakshepa means vikshepa. So the idea is that for a mumukshu, all kinds of vikshepa is to be given up. That's all. As we said earlier also number of times, that Vedantin has nothing against karma as such. He is only committed to knowledge. And knowledge requires a mind that enjoys a total leisure. A freedom from any demands and distractions, internal and external. And as much as nitya karma is a kartavya duty, therefore there is a certain burden to perform those. And therefore, they also should be given up. Then alone, this mumukshu can enjoy that frame of mind where he can see this truth. So that is the explanation here. Kamyadi karmavattesham mano vyakshepa hetutah. See, nitya karma also bring about a mano vyakshepa, mano vikshepa. They also bring about a distraction of the mind, a little burden on the mind. Therefore, tyagah. अतः चोद्यते श्रुत्या नित्यानविकर्मणम् अतः नित्यानविकर्मणम् त्यागः श्रुत्या चोद्यते. Therefore, Shruti in fact here tells us that choditam is what is dharma actually, vidhi, yeah. Because it's so, that is this chodana. So, chodana lakshana dharma. That chodana means vidhi. And then vidhiyate. That's the reason why Shruti even enjoins here the renunciation of nitya karma also. Because like kamya karma, nitya karma also bring about a distraction of the mind. That is why. Ata shabdasya pura panchamya sambandha. So, mano vyakshepa hetutah. That's all. Ataha need not have been stated actually. But anyway, ataha. So, because two fifth case are there, both of them mean the same. So, mano vyakshepa hetutah. Shrutya nityana vikarmanam tyagah chodyate. Okay, then continuing. Tika says further. Nitya karmanam chitta vikshepakatvebi tat yagadrute mumukshunam apekshita jnanasya kamyadi tyagadeva siddhehe tat yaga chodana vrutha iti ashankyaha. Alright, then. Nitya karmanam chitta vikshepakatvebi. Alright, we accept that nitya karmas do bring about a chitta vikshepa. They do bring about a certain activity. They require certain activity of the mind. And therefore, they do bring about a certain distraction. Even then, tatyagadrute mumukshunam apekshita jnanasya kamyani tyagadeva siddhe. So the question is that for a mumukshu, mumukshu need not give up the nitya karma, even though nitya karma does involve a certain amount of distraction. We say that a mumukshu, even without giving up the nitya karma, by mumukshu is giving up kamya karma, that itself is enough for knowledge to arise. So kamyadi tyagadeva apekshita jnanasya siddhehe. So all that a mumukshu requires is knowledge. we say that the knowledge will take place by Atma Vichara even when he performs Nitya Karma. All he has to do is to give up Kamya Karma. Aishanas must be given up. The thing is that Sarva Aishana Vidin Mukta, what is it? This is Sarva Aishana Vidin Mukta Sanyasi. So Nitya Karma does not involve an Aishana. Sarva Aishana Vidin Mukta Sanyasi. So, fine. If sannyasa means giving up all the ishanas, putreshana, vitreshana, location, that's fine. So all kamya karma is to be given up. And so all ishanas are given up. Nitya karma does not involve ishana. Now we say that for a mumukshu, without giving up nitya karma, even though nitya karma may involve a certain amount of viksheba, without giving up nitya karma, we say that giving up kamya karma creates a condition for knowledge to arise in mumukshu. So, tatyagadrute, without the tyaga of the nitya karma, mukshunam apekshita jnanasya siddhehe, kamadi tyagadeva, merely by giving kamya karma and pratishiddha karma and chapala karma and so forth, so giving all those karmas, then in mumukshu, the knowledge will take place. Therefore, tatyaga chodana vritha. Therefore, this vidhi, this enjoyment of giving a nitya karma does not seem to contribute anything more. So if you say that nitya karma tyaga is meant for giving for knowledge, we say that knowledge can arise even when it's doing nitya karma. So having done nitya karma, that's the end of it. The rest of the time he can do whatever he wants to do. And therefore, there is no reason why Shruti should enjoin the renunciation of nitya karma. Idi ashankyaha bhutvaiti. So explanation is given, mano vyaksheva hetutaha. Because the kam nitya karma also brings about a vikshepa. Then he says that vikshepa is okay. That vikshepa is not so much that the knowledge cannot take place. The vikshepa kamya karma is big, therefore that vikshepa should be given up. And you can retain the vikshepa of kamya karma and nitya karma and still knowledge can take place. Therefore, we say that this enjoyment of renouncing nitya karma does not contribute anything to a mumukshu. To that the reply is given. Bhutva samahitahiti samadhanam vidhasyate chodyasya asambhava asyatra shrutyaiva vihitatvataha. So, further, bhutva, so titikshuhu samahito bhutva iti. So, bhutva samahita means samahito bhutva. That's how it should be, I think, in that. So, bhutva samahita iti samadhanam vidhasyate. We say that the Shruti also is samahito bhutva. One must become samahita. I mean, one must have samadhi. One must have a mind that is completely free from every distraction. Chitta vritti nirodha. So there must be a stoppage of all the thoughts. That is what the Shruti is samahito bhutva. That means Shruti enjoins that the mumukshu must possess a mind that is devoid of all distractions. Therefore, that samadhanam or samadhi is possible only when nitya karma also is given up. Because you say that the distraction of nitya karma is allowed for the knowledge to take place. But we say that Shruti says samahito bhutva. That means that atmaniva atmanam pasyedra pasyati, one can see the atma within oneself only when one enjoys samadharam, otherwise not. That's what Shruti says. That's the reason why, depends on what this word samahita means. If samahita or samadhi means nirvikalpa samadhi ratse, then there is a big, very strong paksha which says that knowledge can take place only in nirvikalpa samadhi. Samahita bhutva, what is samadhi? If samadhi is the same samadhi as in yoga, yoga, chitta vritti, nirodha. As far as yoga is concerned, yoga means nirvikalpa samadhi. And ashtanga yoga is in fact a means for nirvikalpa samadhi. So yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, this samadhi is savikalpa samadhi. That samadhi then becomes the means of nirvikalpa samadhi. Oh, this samadhi should be understood as in two stages. Asampragnya, sampragnya, asampragnya, these are words. So, samahita bhutva means what? If it means nirvikalpa samadhi, then samahito bhutva atmani vatmanam pasyati. Then one sees the atma, within one's own mind, within oneself, let us say, having become samahita. Anyway, that is another point. But here, Shruti says, samahito bhutva samahitasyat, one must actually enjoy a state of mind which is free from all the distractions. Bhutva samahita hiti samadhanam vidhasyate. So not only Shruti enjoins shamaha, damaha, uparamaha, but also enjoins samadhanam. Iti samadhanam vidhasyate. Chodyasya asambhav asyatra. And therefore, your chodyam, that this nitya karma tyaga is not right, is not possible, shrutyaeva vihitatvatah. Since Shruti herself enjoins samadhi, therefore your question that the distraction of nitya karma can be tolerated is not right. Says here the Tika. This question answer is to explore this further, that's all. Idea is, that is not merely to say that all right, so you must give up nitya karma also. Why should you give up nitya karma? So reasoning also must be provided. And what is the purpose behind that? That also Vartikara wants to explain. Not really make a statement of Siddhanta. So just a categorical statement. It is not that. But then reasoning also needs to be provided. And somebody has provided their reasoning. And perhaps that needs a little further refinement, you know. So reasoning provided by somebody is presented here. And Vartikara wants to provide a further refinement. Otherwise, it will become a dogmatic reply. Since Mimamsa are all dogmatic people. Dogmatic means they take the letter, that's all. So Vedantins also take the letter of the Shruti. But they also want to take the spirit of the Shruti. I should not say that Mimamsa are only don't take spirit, but the idea is still, it appears to us that they are very dogmatic people. This is said, that's it, that is what is to be done. So it is stated. Vedanta are more practical people. Says, well, does it serve the purpose or not? What's the vivaksha? What's the purpose of saying it? If Shruti says do this or don't do that, it must have some reason. What's the reason? What is it to be accomplished? So tatpari nirna is important everywhere.